What it do, LB crew? It's your girl LB back with another video, and today I got a special one because you guys know I love food. So guess what we're doing today? A mukbang. And what other topic than to talk about school, because school just started for a lot of you guys. So I have my infinite crew member Jazzy Fizzle, and we're gonna talk to y'all about school and just how she feels about school. I mean, I'm going to school online, so I don't really have the feel of school, but that's gonna be our main focus. First day of school, school topics, how we went through high school, how we made it through high school, all of that stuff in this video. So, you already know, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button either up there or down there, whichever one you're watching me on, and let's get this video rolling. For today's mukbang, we got some taquitos that we're gonna cook in this lovely egg-shaped thing. And this lovely thing, it's called an air fryer. My granny uses it for literally everything, so you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna use it for our taquitos today, you know? We like to do stuff like that. I'll be right back. All right, so first, while Lathan and granny are swimming, we are making all of the food, which includes taquitos, guacamole. And for the ingredients for our guacamole, we have 2 avocados, onion, tomato, and like
homegrown.
Yes, homegrown. My grandmother grows tomatoes. No preservatives, no none of that. Ugh.
The good stuff.
Yeah. And like 3 knives and lemon. Let me go get that lemon. I'm gonna show y'all a cool little trick. Watch this. 1, 2, 3. Boom. I'm a magician with this stuff, man. First off, we're gonna cut our avocados. Cut a bit of them.
See, and at work, I cut them all the time.
Oh.
But we have a special spatula.
Oh. Negative. I literally only cut avocados. Oops. I literally only cut avocados to make guac. Over here, people are like, I don't make guac at home. My dad makes guacamole because he swears he's the best at it.
I'm gonna try it on a trick. So you just put your knife and twist it. Do that all the time at work, and I'd be like, just I'll like bang it against the trash can, like kind of throw it, and it'll fall off. People are, and I do it so cool. I'm actually
been an avocado. Yeah, I have always been an avocado lover, but I've never doubted it. I've always believed in avocado. She was slumped on it. Oh, when we, it was a long time ago, me, her, and our friend Diamond came over, and they both hated avocado, and when I ate avocado like 3 times a day, and each time I ate avocado, I sent it to them on Snapchat.
That was, oh god. I need to like, have guacamole or something mixing it, and people just have like avocado just to eat it. I cannot do that. They'll just put salt on it and just like bite into it.
Oh, yeah, that sounds a little wild, but I don't do that.
Somehow, Lyric and I became friends, but it's softball. It's softball over here. Oh man, so we were like just teammates at that point, and we kind of just don't know, no shade to anyone on the team, but like, so we just, I don't know how to explain it.
Honestly, me neither.
I don't, like, if you think about it, we became friends out of nowhere because it's not like we hung out outside of softball at first, like the first
like
year.
Just like we kind
of
clicked.
Just over time it started happening, like say when we became juniors, since we had off-campus lunch, we started having lunch and stuff.
Oh yeah, we used to go to lunch together. That used to be like the funnest time ever. Like honestly, y'all don't understand how close that is to me now. Y'all saw her this the other day, like, when she's gone, I don't be doing nothing. Chef LB, look at the minced onions. That's rich.
Yeah, we've just been friends ever since. And I'm going into my junior year of college, so it's been a while.
Yeah.
And out of all the people from high school, I think she's the only one I really talk to. So, y'all should comment your favorite song from this song.
We got some taquito, some of our sauces, boom. You guys just saw your sauce after the guac, boom.
Ooh, you can't see.
Look at that. Look at all that goodness on that plate right there. Got my water because I'm having salsa, and salsa is hot. And I'm probably gonna down my whole water.
Water with lemon.
And let's get talking. I really wish, because originally my major was what Jazzy's major is. Your major is kinesiology, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have the same major. Well, my major's still the same, but I used to want to be an athletic trainer. I still kind of do. It's like something that's like always been like a, oh, I could be on the football field to help football players out, like wrap ankles, something that I really like to do because I love sports.
Kind of the same too. Well, I mean, like it is, but I'm just kind of going the longer route. So I'm planning on going to physician's assistant school to be a PA. That way I could still like actually work in a doctor's office or a hospital.
Because with sports medicine, you're there for like 2 years and you're done. And you're able to be on the field already, which is pretty fast in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
But it's still a good occupation, especially if you love sports and you love helping people out. That's definitely for you.
Yep.
Like, boom. I already found a career that you love, right?
And when you say athletic trainer, people always think like that you're in the gym training people. I'm like,
No. Like, people feel like that's like a personal trainer.
I'm dead.
Yeah. Okay, that's another thing. I really didn't know. I had like a dumb moment because I didn't know 11-year-olds go to sixth grade. Sixth grade is a big number. Like, to me, in my mind, I was like, what? Don't you mean like the fourth? Like, I can't, like, thinking about it in my head, I can't imagine like a 6-year-old going to the first grade. But you don't start school when you're one. You start when you're five. So you see where I was thrown off, right?
I think they're doing a thing where they're going to start kids at like 3.
Really?
Start going to school, yeah.
I remember this little boy while I was at work, he said, I'm going to TK something. I was like, I don't know what that is, but you go, boo.
Right.
Because he was like 4 years old, because it was during toddler time. As soon as he told me, his little brother started, well, I'm going to first grade. And I said, oh my gosh, that's crazy. So nothing was ever my fault though. Like, I don't, I get that you mess up as a team, but I wasn't messing up. I was doing what I was supposed to do.
Mm-mm. I don't know about that.
I was not. I said when I was mad, of course I'm gonna mess up.
Mm-hmm.
But,
You know what it was? I'll let y'all in on a secret. Got mad or something. There would be times where she's not necessarily doing anything wrong, but so we were supposed to. So she was outfielder, right? I'm infielder. So like she was throwing it in. So she was an outfielder, and I'm an infielder. And so she would have to throw it in or throw it to the cutoff, whatever. I don't know if you understand the lingo. So
yeah.
Just keep it simple. She would just have to throw the ball. And like she said, she would be mad or something. This was before her and I were like super close, so we were new teammates, just met her. We would get mad at her. And I know if any of y'all watching this right now and you're on the team, you know what I'm talking about. Because she would throw it and just, like, let herself go. Like, she wouldn't use the right form. She would just throw it. She looked like a noodle.
But it got to where it needed to go. Yeah.
Just not efficiently, but yes, it would get there.
It got there.
It would just be mad, like, because then that's when Coach Nicky would be like, do it again. Because then we got to wait on lyrics. She'd be,
Well, the thing is, don't make me mad and I'll do it right the first time. So we won't have to redo it over and over and over
again. But it was good times.
So for like elementary school kids, have fun.
Yes.
Tell your parents one thing every day. Something new that you learned. Tell your parents what you learned.
If you didn't learn anything, just tell them your favorite part of the day.
Right. For my middle school kids, try to pay attention. It's still serious because you're about to go into high school.
Right.
Just still kind of have fun, but also make sure you're paying attention. High schoolers, it's going to be very hard. And I'm not faking. It was very hard for high school. My freshman year was it was doozy. After that, it got a lot easier. So you just have to figure out where you get in. If you don't fit in, oh well. Right. Like, it doesn't matter. Because you're not going to see any of those people anymore. But college people, you already know what you're doing because you're up there. Just keep doing what you're doing because you're already as awesome as it comes. If you're not going to school, I know you're still awesome.
Yeah.
So
don't give up.
Yep. Keep doing what you're doing. If you have a dream that you're following and that doesn't require college,
Go for it.
If you're not going to school, you don't want to slack because then you're missing out on money that you could be making. That means you're missing out on stuff you could be buying. And I love to shop, so I'll be the first one to tell you that. Shout out to my lovely granny. Thank you for the food. I really hope you guys liked the video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, you know, because I like thumbs ups. They're great. Also, if you haven't already became one of our crew members, you can go ahead and hit that subscribe button. You already know where it could be. Yep. This video's comment shout out goes to Amelia. Thank you so much for subscribing to the LB crew and becoming a part of the lovely LB crew. If you too would love a comment shout out, all you gotta do is subscribe to this video, like this video, and comment when done. Okay? And again, I hope you guys have a blessed school year and everything goes all in your favor. And if it doesn't, I know you have the tools to turn it around and make it great.
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget to tell your family and your friends about subscribing to my channel because I'm doing a giveaway. It's still on the table. Once I hit 100 subscribers, I'm giving away some free stuff. Jazzy is leaving. Leaving me.
Week.
Yeah, she's leaving next Friday. So this is probably going to be the last time you guys see her for a cool minute. But don't fret. She will be back.
I always come back.
She's an infinite member of the LB crew. And she's a part of the team.
So have a good school year as well. And just a good year.
Yeah.